secured Falcon. I say again, we have secured Falcon.
Gesture of our gratitude, we'd like to offer you, let's call it a favor. The nature of it is your choice. Just tell the operator, Oxford's not rogues, and then I'll know it's you.
I don't want your help. I want my husband back.
What's your name, Edna?
Exe.
Hello, Exe. I see that. You take care of this. Exit. All right. And take care of your mum, too.
Strict instructions not to hurt you.
Look, you've made a mistake. I'm a university lecturer. I've got no money.
This isn't about money. Our boss just wants to talk to you.
Am I meant to find that reassuring?
He'll be here soon. He'll explain. Do you like whiskey? Right. You're the 62 Dalmont. Honestly, this whiskey is amazing. You will shit.
Asking to borrow a cup of sugar is a step too far. It'd be a sin to spill any.
Don't you think?
Thank you.
my kind of welcome.
No stomach for violence. I mean, literally. I see one drop of blood, that is me done. I'm like, projectile. Listen, I'm so sorry you had to witness all this unpleasantness due to our uninvited guest. But I promise you, by the time I found out who he works for, you and I will be the best of friends.
To the shop, please. Arthur's in the dining room, sir.
Beginning to wonder if we were going to have a double toast. Gentlemen, I'm thankful to say it's been 17 years since we last had occasion to use this decanter. Lancelot was an outstanding agent and a true kingsman. He will be sorely missed. To Lancelot.
To Lancelot.
I intend to start the selection process for Lancelot's replacement tomorrow. I want each of you to propose a candidate and have them report to UKHQ no later than 9 p.m. GMT. Thank you. Merlin, come in. Lancelot was investigating a group of mercenaries who were experimenting with biological weaponry.
Glasses, gentlemen, please. Uganda, 2012. Synthetic cathinones. They put it in the water supply of a guerrilla army base. Rage, cannibalism, multiple fatalities. Chechnya, 2013. Insurgents turned on one another. Indisputably the work of our mercenaries, but no trace of any chemicals of any kind.
So what happened to Lancelot?
He tracked them to this property in Argentina. While he had them under surveillance, he became aware they defected a kidnapping. So he executed a solo rescue mission, which failed. This is his last transmission.
Who is he?
Some climate change doomsayer expounds something called Gaia theory about the world healing itself or some such. But what's curious is he's not actually missing. Is this Professor Arnold? At Imperial College this morning.
It's all yours. And don't forget your membership proposal. Try picking a more suitable candidate this time.
17 years, and still evolving with the times remains an entirely foreign concept to you. You don't remind you I wouldn't be here if it weren't for that young man. He was as much Kingsman material as any of them. More so.
But he wasn't exactly one of us, was he? Let's face it, Galahad. Your little experiment failed.
With respect, Arthur, you're a snob.
With respect.
The world is changing. There's a reason why aristocrats developed weak chins.
Don't get some.
Get me stuff.
Oi, have I said to you about speaking to Dean like that?
Freezer crowd, innit? Why don't the intruder go?
I'll tell you what. Why don't you take this guy and get some lizards? Get yourself some sweets. And while you're gone, we'll show your mother if we can be good company.
Thanks, Dave.
So bad. Why don't you leave him?
Low self-esteem.
That's no problem. Fuck off. I would see you have low self-esteem. Makes his mum's well fit.
No, thanks, mum.
It's all right. One of these days, I'm going to smash his face in.
Are you mental, cuz? He'd just get that lot to do you and then pretend he knew nothing.
About it.
Hey! You think you can chat shit about us and he won't do nothing just because our governor's banging ex's mum?
Pretty much, yeah.
Well, just leave. Let's just go, man. It's not worth it.
You boys have outstayed your welcome.
Leave.
What?
sorry about that, bro. Yeah, what fucking worth it, boys?
It's freezing.
Why are we walking?
You jacked his fucking car keys, bruv.
Yep. Now we're gonna nick his car.
Fucking shit. What the fuck?
Hold on, boys.
Customer complaints, how may I help you?
My name's Iggy Unwin. Sorry, Gary Unwin. And I'm up Shit Creek. I'm in Holborn Police Station, and my mum said to call this number if ever I needed help.
Sir. Wrong number.
Wait. Oxford's not Bros.
Your complaint has been duly noted, and we hope that we have not lost you as a loyal customer.
Sorry,
Exit. Classified.
But my dad saved your life, eh?
The day your father died, I missed something. If it weren't for his courage, my mistake would have cost the lives of every man present. So I owe him. Your father was a brave man. A good man. Having read your files, I think you'd be bitterly disappointed in the choices you've made.
You can't talk to me like that.
Huge IQ, great performance at primary school. Then it all went tits up. Drugs. Petty crime, never had a job.
Oh, you think there's a lot of jobs going around here, dear?
Doesn't explain why you gave up your hobbies. First prize, regional under-10s gymnastics, 2 years in a row. Your coach had you pegged as Olympic team material.
Yeah, well, when you go around someone like my stepdad, you pick up new hobbies pretty quick.
Of course. Always someone else's fault. Who's to blame for you quitting the Marines? You're halfway through training, doing brilliantly, but you gave up.
Because my mum went mental. Banging on about losing me as well as my dad. Then what we being cannon fodder for snobs like you? Judging people like me from your ivory towers with no thought about why we do what we do. We ain't got much choice. You get me? And if we was born with the same silver spoon up our asses, we'd do just as well as you. If not better. What the fuck are you doing here? You're taking a piss.
Some more examples of young men who simply need a silver suppository.
No, there are exceptions. Come on.
Nonsense, we haven't finished our drinks.
After you nicked his card, Dean says you're fair game. Ain't I give a shit what your mum says.
Listen, boys. I've had a rather emotional day, so whatever your beef with Eggsy is, and I'm sure it's well-founded, I'd appreciate it enormously if you could just leave us in peace until I finish this lovely pint of Guinness.
You should get out of the way, Grandad. You'll get hurt and all.
He ain't joking, you should go.
Excuse me.
You're looking for another rent boy. They're on the corner of Smith Street.
Manners maketh man. Do you know what that means? Then let me teach you a lesson. We're going to stand around here all day, or are we going to fight? To let off a little steam. Heard yesterday a friend of mine died. He knew your father too, actually. Now, I do apologize, Eggsy. I shouldn't have done this in front of you.
No, please, I won't say nothing, I swear. If there's one thing I can do, it's keep my mouth shut.
You won't tell a soul.
House of Feds, I've never grossed anyone up.
Is that a promise?
All my life.
Much appreciated, Eggsy. You're right about the snobs. But there too, there are exceptions. Best of luck with everything.
In celebrity news, the Richmond Valentine movie premiered in Hollywood last night. The story of the internet billionaire's rise to power is expected to be this award season's hot ticket. One notable absence from the red carpet was Iggy Azalea, still missing 3 days after she failed to appear at a local conference. No ransom.
Shut the fuck up! Who was with you in that fucking pub? I want to know the name of the geezer you was with.
It was a whiplower.
What?
I know what you're on about.
Who was it?
I know what you're fucking on about.
Can you tell me his name?
I know what you're fucking on about.
Thank you.
I've never met a tailor before, but I know you ain't one.
Come with me. Come on in. What do you see?
Someone wants to know what the fuck is going on.
I see a young man with potential. A young man who is loyal. Who can do as he's asked. And who wants to do something good with his life. Did you see the film Trading Places?
No.
How about Nikita? Pretty woman? All right. My point is that the lack of a silver spoon has set you on a certain path, but you needn't stay on it. If you're prepared to adapt and learn, you can transform.
You know, like in My Fair Lady.
Oh, the awful surprises. Yes, like My Fair Lady. Only in this case, I'm offering you the opportunity to become a Kingsman.
A tailor?
A Kingsman agent.
Like a spy?
Of sorts. Interested?
You think I've got anything to lose?
Since 1849, Kingsman tailors have clothed the world's most powerful individuals. By 1919, a great number of them had lost their heirs to World War I. That meant a lot of money going uninherited. A lot of powerful men with a desire to preserve peace and protect life. Our founders realized that they could channel that wealth and influence for the greater good. So began our other venture. An independent international intelligence agency operating at the highest level of discretion. Above the politics and bureaucracy that undermine the integrity of government-run spy organizations. The suit is a modern gentleman's armor. The Kingsman agents are the new knights.
I think this fucking thing got me enough.
Father had the same look on his face. As did I.
Come on.
Galahad. My code name.
Wait again, sir.
Good luck.
In you go.
All in.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Merlin. You are about to embark on what is probably the most dangerous job interview in the world. One of you, and only one of you, will become the next Lancelot. Can anybody tell me what this is?
Yes. Body bag, sir.
Correct. Charlie, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Good. In a moment, you will each collect a body bag. You will write your name on that bag. You will write the details of your next of kin on that bag. This represents your acknowledgement of the risks that you're about to face, as well as your agreement to strict confidentiality, which incidentally, if you break, will result in you and your next of kin being in that bag. Is that understood?
Excellent.
Fall out.
Roxanne, but call me Roxy.
I'm Eggsy.
Eggy.
No, Eggsy.
Eggy,
where'd they dig you up?
You know we're not allowed to discuss who proposed us.
No need to bite his head off.
Charlie's only making conversation, right, Charlie?
Hmm. I'm Digby. Digby.
Eggy.
This is Rufus.
Rufus Eggy.
So?
Peggy. Are you Oxford or Cambridge?
Neither. St. Andrews.
Durham. No, wait, I think we may have met. Did you serve me at the McDonald's in Winchester service station?
No. But if I had, I'd have given you an extra open a secret sauce.
That's definitely St. Andrews.
Just ignore them. You need a pen?
Cheers.
Amelia, isn't it? Amelia? Exie. Hi, Exie. Don't take any notice of those guys. That's what I told him. It's just scare tactics. Classic army technique. No one's gonna die.
Shame.
Great. You don't know, the CIA don't know, nobody knows who this guy is? Fine. Seriously, that's fine. Well, it's not really fine, but it's not why I'm here. Yo, man, you know me. Money's not my issue. I could have retired straight out of MIT, fucked off to some island, let the business run itself. Nobody told me to try and save the planet. I wanted to. Climate change research, lobbying, years of study, billions of dollars, and you know why I quit? Because the last time I checked, the planet was still fucked. Hence, my epiphany. Money won't solve this. Those idiots who call themselves politicians have buried their heads in the sand and stood for nothing but re-election. So I spent the last 2 years trying to find a real solution. And I found it. Now, if you really want to make the world a better place, I suggest you open your fucking ears, because I'm about to tell it to you.
Go on, Mr. Valentine. I'm still listening.
As long as you agree, all my terms.
Congratulations on completing your first task. Charlie, Roxy, well done. For those of you who are still confused, if you can get a breathing tube around a U-bend end of a toilet, you have an unlimited air supply. Simple physics, worth remembering. Exit. Well done for spotting that was a two-way mirror.
Probably seen enough of them.
Yeah, you can all wipe those smirks off your faces. Because as far as I'm concerned, every single one of you is failing. You all forgot the most important thing. Teamwork.
So much for classic army technique.
Five. That's it.
Hello. Can I help you?
Yes. I have a question about anthropogenic force.
Oh, really? Well, it's actually quite fascinating.
My colleague died trying to rescue you, and I'm sure you saw how well-trained he was, so I suggest you tell me who kidnapped you and why they let you go.
I have no idea what the top... I'm not the nurse! saying, but it was...
For God's sake, I nearly touched you.
Emergency and surveillance system work.
You know what's not good news? My colleague died. That's what he said. This is an organization and they're all over us. Whoever you spoke to...
I told you. I made contact with the KGB, MI6, Mossad, and Beijing. Y'all insist he wasn't one of theirs.
Beijing. So freaky how there's no recognizable name for the Chinese Secret Service. Now that's what you call a secret, right? You know what? Fuck it. We need to speed things up. Bring the product release forward.
We're only halfway to production. The speeding it will cost a fortune.
I look like I give a fuck. Just get it done.
As some of you will have learned last night, teamwork is paramount here at Kingsman. We're here to enhance your skills, test you to the limit. Which is why you're going to pick a puppy. Wherever you go, your dog goes. You will care for it. You will teach it. And by the time it's fully trained, so will you be. Most of you are still here. That is. Do you understand? She's your puppy.
The poodle.
What? They're gun dogs. Oldest working breed. Easy to train. A pug.
It's a bulldog, isn't it? It'll get bigger, though, won't it?
His MRI shows no signs of concussion. No direct brain trauma at all.
How much longer can he be out?
That's the million-dollar question. We don't know what he was exposed to in there.
What about Harry's footage? It didn't stream to his home terminal.
Encrypted and uncrackable. If and when he comes round, you might want to have a word with him about sharing his password.
Is he going to be all right?
We need to have patience, Eddie. There's hope. Okay? If I were you, I'd concentrate on your training. Make it through the test. Make it proud.
Come on! I'm not coming after you. Jamie, I'll shoot you, God, I'll fucking shoot you. Merlin says I'm not allowed to hold you. Bollocks.
Exactly 1 hour to complete the test, starting now.
You target 800 meters.
Yeah, that's unbelievable. You're still here, lingering like some steaming shit that just went flush.
Roger that. Target identified, and how about you shut the fuck up?
Positive discrimination, that's what it is. It's like those fucking state school kids who get into Oxfam C grades. Because their mum was a one-legged lesbian.
You don't know fuck all about my grades.
Oh, forgive me, I'm sure you're highly educated. Fire when ready.
How's that for positive discrimination?
Thank you both for listening, and I really, really appreciate you traveling all this way, Your Royal Highness.
And you too, Clemens.
I think this is quite brilliant. It's absolutely brilliant.
You are completely crazy. När jag är statsministern, chockad över att du överhuvudtaget överväger här. Du är vald av folket. Det är ditt jobb.
Sorry, Your Royal Highness.
but you've got a big role to play in getting the Scandinavian region back on track. You're popular, inspirational, and you have the power to galvanize the people. Now, whether you're on board or not, I'm going to have to insist on getting you somewhere I can ensure your safety. How about you, Prime Minister? You in or out?
Well, I think it's about time that a politician did something that, actually made the difference.
Too true.
What?
Take her away.
I see a call. It's a call to murder.
Great. Why not?
Right, then. Yeah!
Don't worry. No harm will come to the Prentice.
Well, I'm a Republican anyway, so it really doesn't matter.
Release the Prentice!
The rob. Merlin said you wanted to see me?
I hope JB's training is going as well as yours is.
Sit.
Congratulations on making it to the final six candidates.
Your test results were even better than I could have hoped.
Come in.
Exit. I need to have a private conversation. You're dismissed.
Nonsense. Let them observe.
I'd learn a thing or two.
As you wish. Take a look at this.
Fucking hell. That's his rank, Harry. You blew up his head. It's a bit much, innit?
Actually, the explosion was caused by an implant in his neck. Here, under the scar.
Did my hardware pick up the signal that triggered him?
Fortunately, yes. Unfortunately, the IP address I traced it to is registered to the Valentine Corporation.
Oh, that's not much of a lead. He has millions of employees worldwide.
No. Richmond Valentine is a genius. Did you not see his announcement today?
No.
We each spend on average $2,000 a year on cell phone and internet usage. It gives me great pleasure to announce those days are over. As of tomorrow, every man, woman, and child can claim a free SIM card compatible with any cell phone, any computer, and utilize my communications network for free. Free calls, free internet for everyone. Quiet.
Valentine's assistant has the same implant scar. I think Mr. Valentine and I should have a tête-à-tête.
He's having a gala dinner next week. I'll get you an invitation. You need to be careful, though. Since you've been out, hundreds of VIPs have gone missing. No ransom notes, exactly like Professor Arnold.
And I suggest you make my alias somebody worth kidnapping.
Follow me, yeah?
why you're all very cheerful.
You really think it was going to be that straightforward? Any idiot can read a heads-up display. A Kingsman agent needs to be able to solve problems under pressure. Like what to do when one of your group has no parachute.
Hello!
Oh, which one? What are you doing? I told you, here's the target coming under the radar. I hope not to be scraping one of you up. But if I do have to and you're inside the target, please know I'm very impressed.
Everyone listen, I've got back! Tear up! Get the coast of price and proof! Coopers, come on! Oh, shit! Look out! Oh, God! Rufus, you wake up! Yeah, we're in our number now! Quick, make the circle! Fucking right, let's do it! We pull our cars 1 by 1, and we know Spice, the person on their right, brother!
Good plan, Exe. We have 30 seconds. Come on, now, hurry up.
Be fast! See you around, boys. No matter what happens now, I've got you, all right?
That's pretty ballsy. Well done for completing another task. Follow.
Sorry, sir. But why the fuck did you choose me as the gimp? Am I the expendable candidate?
No. You don't talk to me like that. You have a complaint. You come here and you whisper it in my ear. You need to take that chip off your shoulder.
In a 1937 Chateau Yquem for Buddy.
I like it. So, you want to donate to my foundation. You are aware that I've wound things down in that area, right?
Climate change is a threat which affects us all, Mr. Valentine. And you're one of the few powerful men who seems to share my concerns.
Well, I shut things down because I wasn't getting anywhere.
Every bit of research kept pointing to the same thing.
The carbon emissions are a red herring, and then we're past the point of no return, no matter what remedial actions we take.
Oh, you know your shit.
I sometimes envy the blissful ignorance of those less well-versed in their shit. As Professor Arnold always said, humankind is the only virus cursed to live with the horrifying knowledge of its host's fragile mortality.
Well, not a lot of people knew about him. You like spy movies, Mr. DeVere?
Nowadays, they're all a little serious for my taste. The old ones. Marvelous. Give me a far-fetched theatrical plot any day.
The old Bond movies. Oh, man. Oh, when I was a kid, that was my dream job. Gentleman spy.
I always felt the old Bond films were only as good as the villain. As a child, I rather fancied a future as a colorful megalomaniac.
What a shame we both had to grow up. Bon appetit. Just give me a couple of days to think over your proposal. I have my people get in touch with yours, and it's all good.
And thank you for such a happy meal.
Well, want me to follow him?
Put a nanotracker gel in the wine. We'll know his every move for the next 24 hours. Finally find out who he worked for.
Valentine didn't let me out of his sight. All I got was this on the way in. Southglade Mission Church is a hate group based in Kentucky. FBI have been monitoring them for years.
But you think Valentine is a supporter?
No evidence yet of a direct connection, but I'll keep looking.
Oh, by the way, our ever-growing list of missing persons now includes Scandinavian royalty. Royal Crown Princess Tilde.
Just let me out, you psycho!
I told you, you're free to go anytime you want, as long as you agree to my conditions.
I don't agree. And I am never, ever going to agree!
Oh, shit. Okay.
The list of missing celebrities and dignitaries has continued to grow in recent weeks, and world leaders are coming under increasing pressure to provide answers.
We are doing everything in our power to find Princess Tilde. You know, governments and security forces worldwide are working together to find the person behind these abductions.
In other news, people all over the world continue to wait in line day and night to get their free SIM cards.
Mrs. P. Did you get one?
Yeah. I've been queuing up all day.
This unprecedented giveaway by the philanthropist Richmond Valentine has already seen over 1 billion cards distributed.
A tease.
So you thought we were done for the day, huh? Well, we're not.
A party.
Tonight, in London.
Who's this?
Your target. Your mission is to use your NLP training to win over the individual on the photograph in your envelope. And when I say win over, I do mean in the biblical sense.
Easy. Flush girls love a bit of rough.
We'll see about that, yeah.
We certainly will.
Hi. Sorry, I just had to come over and say, amazing eyes. You wearing colour contacts?
No!
You so are.
Oh my God, negging. That's hilarious. I haven't heard anyone try that since the noughties. Excuse me? Negging. Saying something negative to a pretty girl in order to undermine her social value. It's supposed to make you want to win his approval. Absurdly basic neuro-linguistic programming technique.
Is it just me, or does this champagne taste a little bit funny?
It's an acquired taste, mate.
I think it's just cheap. Get one of these instead. They're delicious.
You know, if you're into seduction techniques, this guy is textbook. See what he just did?
It's called an opinion opener. Got you talking with a neutral question. Got all of us involved in conversations so that you crave individual attention.
Ma, I'm just saying the champagne tastes right.
Lady Sophie Montague Harry. Phone call for you at reception.
Be right back.
We'll see you in a bit, yeah?
See you in a bit.
Good job, Brooks. I'm feeling a bit rough.
You all right?
Oh, sorry to eavesdrop, but you know there's a much easier way to guarantee getting someone home. You're a hypno. Or even something stronger.
Who the fuck are you? Where am I?
This knife can save your life. My employer's got two questions for you, Exe. What the fuck is Kingsman? And who's Harry Hart?
Who the fuck is? Shit!
Oh, Exe, I just killed two of your friends who give me the same bullshit answer.
Fuck! Just cut the fucking off, please!
Exe! Kingsman worked dying for.
Congratulations. Bloody well done.
Not devastating.
Foxy passed with flying colors. Charlie's up next. Want to watch?
Yeah, all right.
These kings weren't really worth dying for.
No, it fucking isn't, shit. I'll tell you what you won't believe. Get the king and Arthur. Arthur's head of a spy agency. Gold kings, get me out of here.
Thank you, Charlie. Much appreciated.
God, someone just fucking killed.
I had such high hopes for you. You're a bloody disgrace.
Arthur, I'm sorry. You need to untie me.
Untie yourself.
Arthur, please.
Oh, shit. Anyone? No!
Bellahan, Percival, congratulations. Your candidates have reached the final stage of the testing process. As tradition allows, you now have 24 hours to spend with them. Exley, you should know your father reached this point. From now on, there are no safety nets, understood? Good. Dismissed. Charlie, time to go home.
Fuck you! Fucking dad's gonna hear about this!
To pee or not to pee?
That was the headline the day after I defused a dirty bomb in Paris.
Germany 1, England 5.
Missed that game. I was breaking up an undercover spy ring at the Pentagon. My first mission, foiled the assassination of Margaret Thatcher.
Not everybody would thank you for that one.
The point is, Eggsy, nobody thanked me for any of them. Front page news on all these occasions was celebrity nonsense. Because it's the nature of Kingsman that our achievements remain secret. A gentleman's name should appear in the newspaper only 3 times. When he's born, when he marries, and when he dies. And we are, first and foremost, gentlemen.
Me fucked then. Just like Charlie said, I'm just a pleb.
Nonsense. Being a gentleman has nothing to do with the circumstances of one's birth. Being a gentleman is something one learns.
Yeah, but how?
All right, first lesson. You should have asked me before you took a seat. Second lesson. How to make a proper martini.
Yes, Harry.
God damn it! This fucking hurts!
You're the one who asked for a biometric security system. What's wrong with a simple switch?
A simple switch? This is an extremely dangerous machine. It should only be operated by someone as responsible and sane as me. Bad shit could happen if this falls into the wrong hands. We done here?
Shit. No. Now this one. For the test of the church.
This one just has a short range. A simple switch won't do.
So you're gonna teach me how to talk proper like a mighty lady?
Don't be absurd. Being a gentleman has nothing to do with one's accent. It's about being at ease in one's own skin. As Hemingway said, there is nothing noble in being superior to your fellow man. True nobility is being superior to your former self. Now, first thing every gentleman needs is a good suit. By which I mean a bespoke suit, never off the peg. And Kingsman suits are always bulletproof. So let's get you measured, and then whether you get the job or not, you'll have a lasting and useful memento of your time at Kingsman.
I'm so sorry, sir, but a gentleman is completing his fitting. Fitting room 2 is available.
One does not use fitting room 2 when one is popping one's cherry. Perhaps I'll show you fitting room 3 while we wait.
So we're going up or down?
Neither.
This it?
Of course not.
Pull the hook on your left.
Oh, yes. Very, very nice.
You're going to need a pair of shoes to go with your suit. An Oxford is any formal shoe with open lacing. This additional decorative piece is called broguing.
Oxford's not brogues.
Words to live by. Exit. Words to live by. Try a pair. Your weapon scores are excellent, by the way. These you're familiar with. And this is our standard issue pistol. It's quite unique, as you'll see. It also fires a shotgun cartridge for use in messy, close-range situations.
How do they feel?
Yeah, good.
Now do your very best impersonation of a German aristocrat's formal greeting. No, Eggsy.
That is sick.
In the old days, they had a phone in the heel as well.
How do I get it back in?
Well, it's coated one of the fastest acting neurotoxins known to man, so very carefully. Now, I've had a lot of fun with this. One of our finest examples of chemical engineering. A poison, harmless when ingested, but at a time convenient to you, can be remotely activated. Primed. Lethal.
And what about these? What do these do?
Electrocute you. Don't be ridiculous. It's a hand grenade.
Shut up.
You want to electrocute someone, you'll need a signet ring. A gentleman traditionally wears the signet on his left hand, but a kingsman wears it on whichever hand happens to be dominant. Touch the contact behind the ring, it delivers 50,000 volts.
And what about him? What makes him so special?
Nothing. That technology's caught up with the spy world.
Put it back. Exit.
Perfect timing. Gentleman's just finished.
Miss Montemere! What a coincidence. You are totally the reason I'm here. When you left my house, I was thirsting for that dope-ass smoking jacket you had on. And since I'm going to Royal Ascot, apparently you need one of these penguin suits. Here I am. What are you doing here? What's up, man? Risking Valentine.
This is my new valet. I was just introducing him to my tailor.
Another coincidence. So am I.
Have you had any chance to think further on my proposal?
Most definitely. My people will be getting in touch with you very soon. I guarantee it.
A word of advice. Ascot requires top hat. I might suggest Locke and Co. That is St. James's.
Locke, as in smoked fish?
As in locked up.
Oh. I have trouble understanding you people sometimes. Your talk's so funny.
Gentlemen, would you look after him, please?
Now this is a dope-ass pocket. Gabelle, let's go ask about it. Come on,
don't make me late
for the queen.
Come on,
Bill. We're gonna be late.
How far is that, Scott? How far? Mallet,
said you wanted to see me, sir?
Sit down. Pretty dog. What's his name?
JB.
As in James Bond?
No.
Jason Bourne?
No. Jack Bauer?
Oh! Bravo. It pains me to admit it, Exe, but I think that one day you might be as good a spy as any of them. Take it. Shoot the dog.
This weapon is live. Shoot the dog.
At least a girl's got balls. Get out. I knew you couldn't make it. Go home. Merlin, send in Roxy, please. Thank you.
Mom?
Oh, gosh, Ben, I've been so worried about you.
Oh, my days, look how big you've got.
Where is he?
I'm fine. Actually, please, please, just don't
get involved. I should never have left you on your own. This stops right now. Be right back.
Exe.
Right, D. Oh, Muggsy. So you're back. What's gone? Nicked a fucking taxi now?
Yeah. Can I have a word about my mum's black eye?
You want to have a word with me? You get out of that cab, I'll knock you straight back down on your fucking ass.
Tell your muppets to go inside, then I'll get out.
Go on, lads. Maybe two hits. Me hitting him, him hitting the floor. Come on in, you prick. Let's see what you got, eh? Want a bit of me? What are you doing?
No, 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 no,
Carl, you idiot, Matt. Well, you got no bollocks.
Come on, grab him and fucking move.
Come back with your grown-up hair.
Let's see.
Throw away your biggest opportunity over a fucking dog. And then you humiliate me by stealing my boss's car.
You shot a dog just to get a fucking job?
Yes, I did.
Mr. Pickle here reminds me of that every time I take a shit.
You shot your dog and had it stuffed? You fucking freak.
No, I shot my dog and then I brought him home and continued to care for him for the next 11 years until he died of pancreatitis.
What?
It was a blank, Eggsy. It was a fucking blank. Remember Amelia?
Yeah.
She didn't drown. She works in our tech department in Berlin. She's fine. Limits must be tested. But Kingsman only condones the risking of a life to save another.
I might have saved your life even though your fuck up cost it. What have you got in stuff there and all?
Can't you see that everything I've done has been about trying to repay him?
Harry, listen to this. Valentine's a life saying something of naught.
You know what I love about pen and paper? Nobody can hack into this yet. Our World War II was a complete success. We have total coverall. Like when all your numbers and bingo are crossed out.
Bingo?
Bingo. The game. You have played bingo, right?
Do I look like I play bingo?
The point is, if our tests go well at the church tomorrow, we are good to go.
South Glade Mission Church. Well, get the plane ready.
Well, I...
Harry, I'm so sorry. I'm going to do it.
You should be. You just stay right there. I'll sort this mess out when I get back.
And I say to you, bear witness. Watch the news. Watch the news. Hate. Blood. The blood of the innocent spilled. And yet, there are those who doubt this is the wrath of God. Our filthy government condones sodomy. Divorce. Abortion. And yet some spilled out. This is the work of the Antichrist. You don't have to be a Jew, a nigger, a whore, or an atheistic science-loving evolution spouter.
Charmel sermon. Can you see Valentine anywhere?
So my friend, although he is a just God, he is justly... from the Almighty...
You sure we're out of range?
We're over 1,000 feet away. What's wrong?
What if the calculations are wrong?
You just have to trust me.
You nigger! Hang lover! And the devil is burning them for all eternity!
Excuse me.
Here you go. Hey, what's your problem?
I'm a Catholic whore, currently enjoying Congress out of wedlock with my black Jewish boyfriend who works in a military abortion clinic. So hail Satan, and have a lovely afternoon, madam.
Oh, shit. He's leaving. I'm starting to tear them off. Hope none of these freaks have our film covers.
Sit down. Oh,
leave this.
Who is this?
You're trying to insult who you are.
Watch this.
hear me?
Harry! Harry, what the heck is going on?
Just trying to quiet down.
I didn't expect it to be that effective.
What kind of response are we talking?
100%.
So everyone's been affected, whether they have a SIM card or not. And we get the added benefit of wiping out the kingdom.
Not yet.
What did you do to me? I had no control. I killed all those people. I wanted to.
Clever, isn't it? In simple terms, it's a neurological way that triggers the centers of aggression and switches off inhibitors.
Transmitted through your nasty free SIM cards, I assume.
You know what this is like? It's like those old movies we both love. Now I'm going to tell you my whole plan, and then I'm going to come up with some absurd and convoluted way to kill you, and you'll find an equally convoluted way to escape.
Sounds good to me.
Well, this ain't that kind of move.
That tends to happen when you shoot someone in the head. It feels good, right?
No, no, it does not feel good. It feels fucking awful.
What? You just killed how many people in that church? This is one guy.
No, 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 they killed each other. Okay, send out the countdown clock. This party starts tomorrow.
See a young man with attention. wants to do something good for his life.
Arthur, Harry's dead.
Galahad is dead. Hence, we have just drunk a toast to him.
Well, and you know what that psycho's doing? How many people around the world have got those SIM cards? Valentine can send his signal to any of them, all of them. If they all go homicidal at the same time, then...
Indeed. And thanks to Galahad's recordings, we have Valentine's confession. The intelligence has been passed on to the relevant authorities. Our work is complete, and a most distinguished legacy for our fallen friend it is, too.
And that's it.
Come and sit down, boy. This is an 1815 Napoleonic brandy, and we only drink it when we lose a kinsman. Galahad was very fond of you. And on this occasion, I think it's acceptable for us to bend the rules a little.
These are kinsmen?
Yes, they're founder members. I want you to join me in a toast. To Galahad.
To Galahad. Harry says you don't like to break rules, Arthur. Why not?
You're very good, Eggsy. Perhaps I will make you my proposal for Galahad's position. Provided, of course, that we can see eye to eye on certain political matters. Can you guess what this is?
We don't have to. Harry showed me. You click it, I die. Before that brandy tasted a bit of shit.
Bravo.
Valentine won you over. Somehow.
Once he explained, I understood.
When you get a virus, you get a fever. That's the human body raising its core temperature to kill the virus. Planet Earth works the same way. Global warming is the fever. Mankind is the virus. We're making our planet sick. A cold is our only hope. If we don't reduce our population ourselves, there's only one of two ways this can go. The host kills the virus, or the virus kills the host. Either way,
the result is the same. The virus dies.
So Valentine's going to take care of the population problem himself.
But if we don't do something, nature will. Sometimes a culling is the only way to ensure that a species survives. In history, we see Valentine as the man who saved humanity from extinction.
And he gets to pick and choose who gets culled, does he? All his rich mates, they get to live. And anyone he thinks is worth saving, he's keeping them safe, whether they agree with him or not.
And you, Exe, in Harry's honor, I am inviting you to be part of a new world. It's time to make your decision.
I'd rather be with Harry.
Thanks. So be it.
The problem with us common types is that we're light-fingered. Kingsman's taught me a lot, but sleight of hand.
Yes, they're founder members.
I had that down already.
You die, little fucking prick.
Safety, we don't have a lot of time.
What are you going to do?
The question is, what are we going to do? One knows who's in Valentine's pocket and who's not. We've no choice. We're going to have to deal with this ourselves. Follow me.
What is this?
I have no idea.
What you're playing with is a prototype personal trans-atmospheric vehicle. It was developed as part of Reagan's Star Wars project. It's pretty basic, but it should still work. We're going to take out one of Valentine's satellites. We're going to break the chain, stop the signal. It'll take him a couple of hours to reroute it, which buys us enough time for you to get me into Valentine's mainframe so I can shut it down. Laszlo, you're going to be using it. Get into your Halo suit.
British Prime Minister requesting permission to land.
So how many more are we expecting?
Not many. Most have their own bunkers. I figure we're just getting the really nervous ones.
Welcome, Prime Minister.
It seems the implant can emit some kind of counter signal to ensure the wearer remains unaffected by the waves from the SIM cards.
The waves just send everyone into a psycho killer.
Quite. The one he probably didn't tell anyone is it can also superheat their soft tissue at his command. Valentine selected his chosen for you to get the countdown warning. We had to be sure they didn't blow up to the wrong people before.
How does this open right now?
He doesn't.
Roxy, here we go! The higher you go, the more the balloons expand. When you reach the edge of the atmosphere, they'll explode. You need to deploy your missile just before that, okay?
Edge of the atmosphere.
And once you're deployed, you'll need to release for descent fast. Good luck.
You can do this, okay?
Edgy, come on, time is not a friend.
Arthur's invitation.
You're gonna need to blend in.
I'm supposed to be Arthur.
His invitation's in his phone. Give him this, give his real name, Chester King.
What about you?
I'm a pilot, I'm gonna stay here.
Is that gonna fit me?
A bespoke suit? Always fits. Just be grateful Harry had it made for you. Get dressed.
What the fuck's wrong with him?
I don't know. Could have something to do with the mass genocide.
Give me the mic. Hey, yo! Everybody listen up! Hello! What the fuck is wrong with you people? I just want to remind you that today is a day of celebration. We must put aside all thoughts of death and focus on birth. The birth of a new age. We mustn't mourn those who give their lives today. We should honor their sacrifice.
But my numbers are going back, I'm fine.
And their role in saving the human race. We must put aside doubt and guilt. You are the chosen people. When folks tell their kids the story of Noah's Ark, is Noah the bad guy? Is God the bad guy? How about the animals marching two by two? Of course not. Yeah, that's it. Let's turn those frowns upside down. Eat, drink, and mourn. And I will see you all in the new age.
Brooks, it's me. How's it been?
Hideous.
Mine's pretty sweet. They made you one of these suits yet?
No, not yet.
You've got something to look forward to then. We're coming up on Valentine's base. Gotta go. Good luck.
Looking good, Eggsy.
Feeling good.
This is November 247 Charlie Kilo requesting permission to land.
Permission is granted.
Fuck me.
Exe, we're on.
Chester King.
Mr. King, welcome. I'm sure you have adhered to Valentine's strict no weapons policy, but if you don't object...
Of course.
Thank you. Do you have any luggage?
Congratulations, Mycroft. You just graduated from my pilot to my valet.
You're cheeky.
Understood? Good. Thank you. Stirred for 10 seconds while glancing at an unopened bottle of vermouth. Thank you. Merlin, are you clocking this?
Yes, I am. Stay focused.
Marcel, you're doing great. Not much further to go.
Yes, Merlin.
Hey, get me online now.
Yep, I'm on it.
Marcel, you're approaching your altitude limit. Those balloons won't last much longer.
You have to engage missile.
Society's dead. Long live society.
Amen to that.
I'm Morton Lindstrom. Chester King. How'd you get online? I couldn't...
Oh, well, it's a closed network, you see. Pre-authorized connections on.
I've got a fix on the satellite.
Do you have the correct time? I think I stepped on my last time zone.
Oh, yeah, yeah, I did see that.
I'm in. Get your ass back to the plane now.
I'm on my way.
Lancelot, good luck. Firing in 3, 2.
Nice and slow.
The fuck are you doing here?
Well, my family were invited. Obviously. I'll get the fuck up.
Slow.
Oh, shit.
Lancelot, hurry up and fire. That other balloon is gonna fall.
Yes, Merlin. I'm nearly got it. Give me a second.
Valentine! I've called a fucking spy!
Big man, boom.
Oh, fuck, it's that young valet!
Son of a bitch!
Good!
Oh, shit! Family alarm!
You're not taking any chances.
Okay, you sent an opportunity warning. I'm starting the override.
All right, let's do it.
Nice.
both of you. It's not working. It's supposed to be working. What the fuck?
Yes, let's get off the goon. We've lost one of our satellites.
Oh, no, no, there's no way I can act past that.
What's going on? Is there a problem? Come on, there's no need for guns. I'm just a pilot.
Get in here! Come on!
Let's get the fuck out of here.
We can't. We can't get into Valentine's machine. It's got biometric security. We're gonna have to get in there and make sure his hand never touches that desk.
Are you taking the fucking piss?
I'm afraid not.
Is that Blackman?
Uh-huh. This is mine. I'll show you yours. Just.
How long to relink this satellite chain?
It'll take an hour, maybe two.
Bullshit! Just bring these two closer together!
But that's not Morse.
D-Glass, call E-Man. E! It's me. Listen, man, I got a little hiccup on this end. I need a piggyback. One of my satellites just went down, but it's right next to one of yours. You read my mind. How long before you make that out?
Go.
All right, we should be coming back online. 10%?
Oh, shit.
Edgy! Valentine's using someone else's satellite. He's gonna reconnect the chain. It's gonna take no time at all. It's at 20%.
Excellent. See, Valentine's got a present for you. Get a move on. Class, you said we're of no use to us.
If he turns, you can turn him on.
I tell you, time to play Valentine.
Oh no, what the fuck is it? I can't stop this.
Please. No!
That is fucking spectacular!
Merlin, you're a fucking genius!
What is happening out there?
Aren't you the princess that went missing?
Can you get me out?
Well, if I do, will you give me a kiss? I've always wanted to kiss a princess.
If you get me out right now, I'll give you more than just a kiss.
You motherfucker. Did you really think I was stupid enough to plant one of those things in my own head? What, are you fucking crazy? All those innocent people killed, and for what? You didn't stop shit!
You're fine, I'm not sure which misses you now. As I said, put your daughter in the bathroom and throw away the police.
It's still happening!
What can you say?
You just do it.
Valentine's hand off that bloody desk there!
Sorry, love. You gotta save the world.
If you save the world, we can do it in the asshole.
I'll be right back.
Good luck! London.
Thank you. Like you said to Harry.
This ain't that kind of movie, bruv.
Perfect.
Exit, where are you going? There's no need for champagne. We got loads in the plane.
Save the world?
Yes, I did.
So, you gonna come in?
Yes, I am.
Well, in the cell's not bad again.
26:25.
He's back. You finally come to have that word with me, have you, son? Or are you going to run away again and pretend you're going to court dressed like that?
Oh, you mean this?
No.
I know this bloke has just taken over a tailor shop on Savile Row. He's given me a job, Mum.
He comes with a lot of perks,
including a house. Come and live with me there, Mum. Come on.
Sit down, you. The only place she'll be visiting is you in fucking hospital. Do you hear?
Just leave him alone, Dean. Exit, go. Please, just go, babe.
Right. Yes, you do as Mummy says. Run your ass that tailor friend of yours and knock up a nice chicken costume and a suit of your mug.
As a good friend once said, manners make us man.
Shove your
manners
up, you
fucker. So, are we gonna stand around here all day? Or are we gonna fight?